We got a bit of a surprise the other day when Lakers guard Avery Bradley decided to switch agents, which gives the impression that he will be opting for free agency instead of picking up the 1 year remaining on his Lakers contract that would pay him about $5 million, which is what we had previously thought was going to happen. And now we have some clarification about why he made a move like that. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. This is the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Make sure you subscribe and don't forget to ring that notification bell right over there. All right, so Avery Bradley, according to Chris Haynes of Yahoo, there are multiple contending teams that are going to attempt to pry Avery Bradley away from the Los Angeles Lakers in free agency. Among those teams are the Milwaukee Bucks and Golden State Warriors. Not great for the Lakers. Why is this such a big deal? Well, because Avery Bradley, while he didn't play in the bubble at all, opted out of going to Orlando, so he didn't participate in the playoffs for the Lakers, but he showed a couple of things last season that teams would really want. And the first of those things is his ability on the offensive end of the floor. That's his ability to cut to the basket. We saw him make some nice plays there. And he shot 36% from deep, which is just above league average. Again, not great or anything like that, but he's good enough to where he can keep defenses honest. And that's important to an offense on a championship contending team like the Bucks, like the Warriors, and of course, like the Lakers. But where Bradley really shines is on the other end of the floor. He is still one of the best perimeter defenders in the NBA. And in fact, this is ridiculous. He negatively impacted opponents' three-point percentage by 11% when he was defending them. That is insane, and it's probably a little bit of a fluky stat, but the bottom line is that he is still very, very good at defending the three-point line. And what are more and more teams doing these days? They're weaponizing the three-point line. So if you can get Avery Bradley out there on the defensive end, that can make a difference and help you win basketball games by stopping teams from getting hot from behind the arc. So Avery Bradley's going to be in high demand because of those things. And if he started to get word that, hey, the Bucks, the Warriors, other teams around the NBA might be interested, then suddenly he starts to feel emboldened to not pick up that player option and stay with the Lakers for next season. Now, the Lakers are actually in a really tricky spot here with their two guards. We've already seen Danny Green got traded away, or he's going to be traded away to the Oklahoma City Thunder for Dennis Schroeder, which I think is still a fantastic deal value-wise for the Lakers. But if Avery Bradley is also opting out and he is leaving, that was the fallback option in case the numbers get a little too high when you're trying to negotiate with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Now the Lakers don't have that if Avery Bradley is hitting free agency and KCP now is in a very strong negotiating position because the Lakers are going to be most likely out of salary cap space, and KCP has the advantage of having bird rights, which means the Lakers can go above the salary cap in order to bring him back. If he were to walk away because they don't have salary cap space, replacing him would be really difficult. So Avery Bradley potentially walking out the door, in addition to Danny Green leaving, just puts Kentavious Caldwell-Pope in a stronger and stronger negotiating position with the Lakers and could lead their offer to him to be higher and higher. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean Avery Bradley is definitely gone. For example, what if the Lakers decide they want to dip into their mid-level exception to keep Bradley around? I mean, that's not out of the question. Maybe that's something that they would want to do. But still, the bottom line is that having all of these players, I'm talking about Dwight Howard, Rondo, who we've already heard is probably on his way out the door, KCP, Avery Bradley now, all of these different pieces that are hitting free agency, Markieff Morris, that's putting the Lakers in a tough spot because there's only so much money to go around and you're not going to be able to bring them all back. I mean, look, that's already seen by Rondo, probably not coming back. The Lakers can't bring everybody back, and how they replace them is going to be up to Rob Pelinka. He's going to have to make the most of some veteran minimum contracts as well as perhaps the mid-level exception and biannual exception. He's going to have to really get some bang for his buck there, because the Lakers want to field a roster that can defend their NBA championship. Let me know, guys, what would you do? Would you prioritize keeping Avery Bradley? Would you dip in to that mid-level exception money in order to keep him around? Would you offer him multiple years? And how high would you be willing to go to keep KCP on the Lakers, knowing that he's going to be a real hard guy to replace? Give me your thoughts. Fire them off in the comments down below. And don't forget, follow Lakers Nation across social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. And if you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.